Protect your DNA. BioPQQ can promote formation of new mitochondria. Infowarsstore.com.
I continue to believe Mr. Trump will not be president.
Can Donald Trump win a general election?
My view is no, but we'll see.
Why not?
Well, if Mitt Romney lost with 27% among Latinos, right, how good would somebody do who's got an 11% approval rating? So
this guy, in my view, is not going to be elected president, okay, and he's got a ceiling.
And your basic argument is that the premise here, he's not going to win all four of those states.
No,
that's what you're saying.
No.
The Fox News decision desk has called Pennsylvania for Donald Trump. This means that Donald Trump will be the 45th president of the United States.
Now it's time for America to bind the wounds of division. Have to get together. To all Republicans and Democrats and independents across this nation, I say it is time for us to come together as one united people.
You're awake, by the way. You're not having a terrible, terrible dream. Also, you're not dead and you haven't gone to hell. This is your life now. This is our election now. This is us. This is our country.
Well, America is crying tonight. I'm not sure how much of America, but a very, very significant portion. And I mean literally crying.
I'm sorry. It's just, it's not okay.
It's okay. It's okay. Take a moment.
Sorry.
When you both consider the events over the next 36 hours.
This was a white lash.
Investigators are also looking into who breached voter databases in the states of Illinois and Arizona. For his part, President Putin has denied any tampering.
I don't know anything about it. And on a state level, Russia has never done this.
Deeper concerns tonight that the world's shining light of democracy has gone dark.
And to further that sentiment of total fear porn now spiraling out of control from the left, Hillary Clinton mouthpiece central, The Washington Post, backed up the website Prop or Not's claim that 200 websites wittingly or unwittingly published or echoed Russian propaganda. Of course, Infowars was at the top of the list, created by four anonymous researchers. The Washington Post's attack on independent media was later modified with a retraction. The Washington Post wrote, "The Post, which did not name any of the sites, does not itself vouch for the validity of Propernot's findings regarding any individual media outlet, nor did the article purport to do so. Since publication of the Post's story, Prop or Not has removed some sites from its list." Regardless of the fact that the Washington Post had engaged in fake news, the very same article went on to lecture its readers on methods of identifying fake news.
How do we do better prices for our audience? Because that's how I want to be treated. Meanwhile, they're just like, how do we screw everyone? Oh, yeah. But then on air, it's like, oh, I'm liberal. Oh, I have the moral high ground fighting racism and sexism and homophobia. Really, Obamacare doubles prices in the first year. Shut up, racist. Why are you getting upset? Because I'm for real. So, self-proclaimed hack journalist calls on social media to censor fake news. Hillary supporters still reeling over devastating laws call for censorship of independent media. I mean, this is like your restaurant can't get any businesses because you got caught with cockroaches in all your food and rat droppings, and it was on the news. The health department shut you down for a week. No one's pulling up to eat your food. No one. What do? You start whispering, oh, yeah, they got cat turds in their food across the street. Oh, yeah, and they got the syphilis on the hamburgers. Yeah, we did it. And then they start calling in health department calls. Oh, you know, Bob's across the street. They're the ones that got really dirty stuff. And then they run over and, like, throw cat droppings, you know, under the bar stools right as the inspector comes in. Look, it's there. Just shut them down.
Hubris is a heavy drug. John Bound for Infowars.com.
Our fellow InfoWarriors across the United States and across the planet really love the Hillary for Prison 2016 shirts that we began to put out in 2015. It became a global meme against globalism and corruption.
and a very strong maxim that's now being continued on today. So we now have George Soros, because the media attacked me on this whole goblin meme, and they've made huge jokes about it, but it's totally blown up in their face. We now have George Soros as a goblin on the back, and it says, with a cross through him, you know, an X like Ghostbusters, no Soros, him as a goblin. It says deport Soros on the bottom, and on the top it says Infowars established 1996. So it is a limited edition deport Soros on the back, Hillary for president on the front, right hand shoulder, Infowars.com. It's powerful. Hope you get out to everybody you know. Infowarsstore.com or call 888-253-3139.